Today we will demo the instrument that is a digital theodolite. Digital theodolite is similar to the vernier theodolite, only the difference is that there is only one motion, hence only one clamp screw and slow motion screw, okay, horizontal as well as vertical. So only one motion clamp and slow motion screw and one vertical clamp and slow motion screw. Rest of the things is same as the vernier theodolite. I will tell about the part of the instrument: lower triangular plate, upper triangular plate and 3-foot screw. This is known as a leveling head. Okay, here you can see there is a circular bubble. Here there is a circular bubble. This bubble you need to bring in the center of the run. Here there is a plate bubble. So this is a longitudinal bubble tube. You can bring this bubble also in the center. So what you will do in this procedure, these 2-foot screws you can set parallel to plate level tube and move both the 4 screws inside or outside and bring the bubble in the center of the run. Then set perpendicular and bring the bubble in the center of the run by moving the 3rd foot screw only, inside or outside. You can also check the leveling of the instrument. You have to mount this instrument on the tripod, okay, and you have to check the station marking on the ground through this optical plummet. This is optical plummet. Through this optical plummet you have to look and you have to check that center of the instrument that is projected from here to the ground, where it is. Is it exactly co-aligned with the station marking as a peg and your instrument center marking? If it is a co-aligned, your centering is perfect. If it is not, you have to bring the peg in the center marking. Okay, so that you can do by moving the leg of the tripod. After that, you should be familiar with the part of the instrument. This is the object glass, okay, and this is the eyepiece. Focusing of the object glass is provided here, and focusing of the eyepiece is just close to the eyepiece ring. Okay, the eyepiece focus is provided here, and the focusing of the glass is here. This is the collimator. This collimator helps you to direct the instrument in a line with the object. Okay, so this is a collimator that helps you to set the instrument in line with the object. Okay, now this is a vertical circle. Here there is a vertical circle. Okay, and here there is a battery clamp. You can open up the battery clamp. Okay, and the battery is needed for the digital instrument, so you have to attach it. This is a handle fixing screw. Handle fixing screw, you can remove it. Okay, you can remove the handle and you can fix the EDM also on this. So that is the modular arrangement is provided over here. This red key helps you to on the instrument. When you on the instrument, the display will be appear. You have to get the bulb on. Then you can illuminate the display. Now the display is illuminated and it start the displaying the angle. Whenever you on the instrument, it will start the displaying the horizontal and vertical angle. Will not ask anything to you. If you want to set 0-0, then you have to clamp it and set 0-0. When you set 0-0, it will set the horizontal angle 0 degree 0 minute 0-0 second. When you unclamp horizontal motion and you rotate, start rotating, it will start the measuring the angle. It will not ask anything to you, it will start measuring the angle. Okay, so it will start the measuring the angle. Here there is a convention that is horizontal angle to the right. Horizontal angle to the right means once you set the line and you are moving to the right, then it is horizontal angle to the right. If you change it by RL, then it is a horizontal angle to the left. Okay, so if you measure 30 degree as a horizontal angle to the right, then 30 degree is the horizontal angle to the left, remaining angle. So minus 360 you get the horizontal angle to the left or right. So whenever you take the reading with the digital level, you have to set first of the line from point A to point B, and you have to move in the desired direction. You want to measure in a left direction or in the right direction, so you have to move accordingly. Okay, now one important key is a zero set. You can set 0 degree 0 minute 0 second at any point. Suppose I want to set here 0 degree, then I can clamp it and set 0 degree 0 minute 0 second. Okay, I can set at any line 0 degree 0 minute 0 second. So that is 0 degree minute second, setting. Okay. Now, in case you have measured some angle, suppose 90 degree, 44, 45 is the reading, and you want to continue with this reading without changing the reading. So there is a hold key. When you hold and you move the telescope or instrument, it will not change the reading. See, now there is no change in the reading. Only 1944, 46 is there. Okay. So in a time, if you want a movement where after taking a one reading, you want to keep those reading and you want to continue like a method of repetition, then you have to hold that reading. When you again key the press the hold, it will unhold. Now it will change the readings. Okay, so that way hold key also help you. Now important is a shift key. This shift key will use for the further function. Suppose you want to use the unit measurement. Okay, so unit you are getting degree, minute, second, but in this case also you are getting unit in the gons. So 0 to 90 degree, normally we are getting 0 to 90, 90 to 180, 180 to 270, and 270 to 0. But in some countries, European countries, they are getting gons, 0 to 100 gon, 100 to 200 gon, 200 to 300 gon, and 300 to 400 gon. Likewise, they are dividing the circle. Okay. Now, about the vertical angle, normally your vernier satellite, you are setting horizontal line is a 0, 0, but here zenith is a 0. Okay, so it will display the vertical circle as a 0 degree. So in angle also it will display that it is a VZ. Okay, display angle is a VZ. So sometimes if the labeling is not there, it will not display. So we will set the labeling. So in a case of the vertical angle, this is a 0 degree, okay, VZ is a 0, then this is a 90 degree, this is a 180, and this is a 270 degree. So likewise it will move the motion. How can you check that this for normally the instruments are designed for the right-handed people. So if with the right hand you can catch the both the foot screw, that is the right condition. So this is a VZ condition, that is a 0 degree in the zenith direction, then 90 degree, 270, and again zero. Okay, so likewise.